गुड मॉर्निंग, आई एम करण राज। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द C4 प्रोग्राम वेयर द कंटेंट्स ऑफ द वन फाइल नीड टू बी स्टोर्ड इन द अनदर फाइल यूजिंग द C प्रोग्राम। आई हैव कलेक्टेड द प्रोग्राम फ्रॉम द स्टूडेंट्स एंड आई हैव चेक्ड इट। सो व्हाइल कमिंग टू द सम ऑफ द मिस्टेक्स दैट इज डन बाय द स्टूडेंट्स, दैट इज कॉमन मिस्टेक्स इज द in the fscanf statement. While coming to the fscanf statement, some of them have included the slash t in the scanf. Please avoid that or do not do that thing or include the slash t in the fscanf. And the next is here. When you write fscanf or the fprinter anywhere, maybe in the here taking the value for the item dot dot, or you are filling the values for the stock of 100 dot dot, you have to be careful about one thing, that number of SS specifier should be same thing. For example, if I'm having 4, that is item number, name, stock and rate, I should have 4 SS specifiers. So some of them are missing 1 or 2 SS specifier, which created the problem in the input. If you miss anything in the SS specifier, that is in this particular region, that is percentage D, percentage S, percentage D and percentage D, you will not get any form of error, but it will give you the wrong output or it will make you to go to infinite loop. Okay, so anything you miss here, that is in the SS specifier, in this place or in this place, you will get to the wrong answer. Why? Because we are mentioning here 4 inputs, but you are only taking only 3 inputs, so that is the cause of the error. So if you notice here, what is done here is, I have percentage D1, okay, so yes, okay, D, so only 3 things are there, but I am collecting it for the 4 values, so that cannot be done. And here, when you are doing the printf statement, no need of having the slash t here. In the other programs, you can have the slash t, but in this program, while coming to the file printer, because you are printing it to the file, no need of having the slash t. Okay, and please make sure that I should have the 4 as a specifier, because I have the 4 variables are currently present with me. Okay, so that is another most common error that is created here, and please be careful about this one also here. So please have the same number of the as a specifier. Here you can have the slash t. Why? Because you are printing it on the monitor. But what about here? You are printing it on the file. Okay? So here also you should have the same matching things should be there. Okay? So 4, if it is 4 variable, then you should have the 4 SS specifiers should be present. So these are the some of the common mistakes that has been done. So I'll open my program and I'll try to solve it. So here I am having two, creating two file pointers, one is file1 and F2, F1 and F2. F1 is for the item dot dot and F2 is for stock dot dot. Okay, the most common mistakes, as I already mentioned, you are missing one percentage D or percentage S, that is in the SS specifier. For example, I will try to execute and show it to you. Let me compile this one. See here, even if I am missing the one SS specifier, it is not going to show any form of the errors. But if I try to execute this one, I am getting the errors. Okay, so please be careful here. You are not going to get any form of the error, but when you execute it, you will be getting the errors. Errors in terms of, you are getting the wrong output. You are getting the wrong output. Why you are getting the wrong output? Because you have given the input only wrong. You have mentioned 4 variables and you are collecting only 3 variables. That is a wrong thing. Okay. Then while coming to here, in the fprinter, please do not have the slash t, because some of them have included the slash t. Please do not do that, because fprinter, you are writing it here to the file. Okay. So, and another thing here, noticeable thing is, name is a character array and you are storing to the file. So file is a stream of bytes. Okay. So no need of having the ampersand. Okay, so that is the one thing. And here, what I recently noticed is, one mistake is you guys are having 3 here, okay? So no problem with the having 3D as my width, okay? So what the problem here is, let me try to execute this one. Let me say just one record. So let me insert the item number, then let me have the items, for example toys, and let me have something like here 4567 something, and here let me have again 4567 something like 8 now. Okay, now you have to notice the input here. I have given the 34 as my item number, toys as my item name, and 4567, that is 4567 as the stock, and 45678 as my rate of that particular 4567 stock. Okay, now let me hit enter. Okay, if you notice here, the either in certain cases the stock will be getting the negative answer, something like here, if you notice it here. Or the rate is going to get the negative answer, or we are going to get the different answer. Okay, why, I will tell you now. And if you notice it here also, in the item that is stock more than 100 also, you are getting the proper output, but you are getting the wrong things, right? You are getting the wrong details here. What is the wrong details? You have entered 45,678 and you are getting 19,858. So you are getting that one. Okay, why you are getting that? Integer is going to collect around 32,000 value, but what you inserted is around 45,678 is what you have entered. So what it is going to do, it is going to take the modulus of the 45,678 with the 32,000, and I am going to get 19,858 as my answer. So you are getting that. Now let me check the file also, that is item.dat, and let me verify the thing with the stock dot dot also. So I have the item dot dot here, so let me open that. So if you notice it here, I'm storing the wrong things, okay, and it is storing the wrong things. That is one reason, is because I am going out of bound of the integer value, that is in the stock also. If you see here also, I'm getting the wrong input only, okay. Why I am getting that is because I am going out of bounds. Okay. Now let me correct them and let me check that. For example, let me give the different input. Again, let me give just one, and let me have something like 34, same thing, toys, and let me have something like 1000. And let me have something like here 15,000. Okay, now let me see. I'm getting the same answer, but what I'm getting here, I'm getting the wrong stock. Okay, I'm getting the wrong stock here. Okay, so let us go and verify the my item dot dot and the stock dot dot. Okay, so item dot dot, I'm getting the wrong things, and here I have stored only 1500, right? I have stored 1500, okay, 1000 only. So it is storing 1000 only, but I'm getting here, if you notice the output here, I'm getting 7064, right? Okay, now let us check about this one also. So stock also, see, in the item dot dot, I am storing 1000, but in the stock, it is getting storing 7064. Why it is doing it? Because if you notice it here, it is together, 1000 and 1500 is printing it together. So it is going to take the 1000 and 1500 together, and it is going to take the modulus of that. So one thing you can do here is, in the program, what I'm going to do here is, okay, before that, let me close the files. Let me close this one also. So one thing what I can do here is, instead of this one, let me insert 5. Now let us see the output. Okay, now let me again execute it. again I give 1, and again I will give the same input, 34 doubles 1000 and 15,000. Okay, now I am getting the proper hour. Why I am getting that? And here stock is also no problem with the stock, no problem with the rate also. Okay, one thing you have to be careful is because you may get the wrong answer or the wrong output because you have gone out of the bounds. So be careful when you give the input, it should be lesser than 30,000 or make sure that you keep it lesser than 20,000. The second thing you have to note down is how it is going to get copied to the item dot dot or the stock dot dot. If you are not giving much space in between the two numbers, the 5 is going to consider it as a single number and it is going to consider it is completely one thing. For example, in the previous example, what we done, it was taking 1000 and 15,000 together, okay, and it was getting printed. Okay, for example, in the item dot dot, there was no problem. But when it was taken by the stock more than 105, so there was a problem. That is, 1000 and 15,000 was taken together and it was taking the modulus of the integer. So that was the problem. That is why you are getting the wrong answer. Okay. Now let me show the item 5 here. See here, proper gap is there between them. And here no problem. Why? Because this is number and this is character. So 5 can separate it very easily. Now let me show the stock also. Stock is around here. Okay. Now see here. Okay. I am getting the proper. Okay. So when you type this file or type this program, please be careful. That is with the number of SS specifier. That is this part. Even if I make any wrong here, I am not going to get any type of the errors. But when it is storing in the my file, that is item, or in the stock, the wrong things will be getting stored. When the wrong things are getting stored, I am going to get the errors in my output. Okay? Why? Because I am storing wrong things. And because I have the 4 variables here, and I should have the 4 SS specifiers. And here, instead of 3, increase it to 5. Okay, increase it to 5. And it is better if you input to this particular line also flush, so that all the stream that is present in the input will get flushed out. Okay. Now, if you notice it here, as I already mentioned, please do not include slash t if you are writing it to the file. So I am writing it to file 1 here, and here I am comparing the values of the F1, because I am taking the values from the F1 and I am checking whether my percentage D, that is this one, so D stop is more than 100. Okay, I am doing that. So when I do that, please make sure also here I have the 4 SS specifier because I have the 4 variables here. Okay, and here also same thing. Please make sure that I have 4 things. Okay, and here in some of the lab manual which I collected or from the students which I collected, sometimes you mentioned F1 here and the same F1 here. No, you have to have F1 here and you should have the F2 here because you are copying it to the stock 100 dot dot. Okay, so that is a one major problem. And here also same thing, F1 and here F2. Now if you study this part, this complete thing, from, let me say, from here to here, then it is a copy paste of this one to here. Okay, but be careful with the file pointer. Here it is F1 and this one will be F2. Okay, and here also F2 is getting open, here F1 is getting open. F1 is getting closed, F2 is get closed here. And here, as I already mentioned, for the fprintf, don't use slash t. But here, I am not writing it to file, but I am writing it to standard output, that is my monitor. For the monitor, I can do the slash t. And be careful with this one, better you keep it file, okay? That means, when I say file, don't enter some values like 5-digit value, do not go to enter it. You can restrict yourself to 4-digit number, so that you have the small gap between the numbers. And make sure that you have the 4 variables and 4 as a specifier. 4 variable, 4 as a specifier, 4 variables. Okay. Please execute it and check. If you are not getting proper output, you can contact me. Execute it again for the verification. Let me enter 2. Okay. 34 is my first one. Then let me have that toys. Okay. Let me have 1000 as my stock. And let me have something like 9000 as the price, stock price. Let me have another record. Let us say that 45 is the item number. And let me have snack as the item. And let me have the stock of around 50. And let me have the price of $5. Now, in the output, for the item, I should display both 34 and the 45. But for the stock, I should only display item number 34. Okay? So, we are getting the proper output. So, 34 is here and 45 stock number is also there. Okay? But while coming to the item, the only stock which is more than 1000 is or 100 is going to get displayed. So only toys are getting displayed here. And it is getting continuous. So what you can have here is you can have the slash n. So printer let me have the slash n and let me have the same thing here. Printf. Okay, and let me show the output again. Let me give the same input. Okay, number of records 2. First record, let me have the 34, toys, and let me have 1000, and let me have something around 9000, and here let me have the 45 as the item number, let me have snack, okay, and let me have the 50 as my stock, and let the price be 5000, okay, so here, getting the proper output. Now let me verify using the 5 also. See, we have 2 records are here and only one record is present here of only toys. Why? Because here item has 2 records where one item you have in the less stock of lesser than 100. Okay.